was interested in making sure we were high enough so a surface-to-air weapon wouldn't shoot us down.
A couple minutes after takeoff, Reggie, the chief flight attendant, called me from right outside the president's office, and he goes, are we out of missile range yet?
I need to know. The president wants to know as soon as we're clear. And I could hear the president yelling, Reginald, are we clear? Are we clear?
We're about at 4,000 feet, and I said, I think once we get above 10,000, we'll be okay.
That was probably the longest ascending time I've ever been on an airplane trying to reach 10,000 feet.
And then about 30 seconds later, he calls me back and says, hey, Chief, are we there yet? I said, no, Reggie, we're not. I said, this ain't the space shuttle, man.
As we got leveled off and were flying, the president asked me to come down to the conference room. As I walked in, they all just started clapping, and they all thanked me for what we had accomplished. I asked the president what Thanksgiving dinner was like, and did he, you know, have a good Thanksgiving dinner? And he was so proud that he was able to serve the troops for dinner. And we had accomplished it. We had got him there so he could be with the troops.
We all understood the historic precedence of taking the President of the United States into Baghdad on that day.
Out of danger, the crew could at last enjoy their own belated Thanksgiving dinner, 40,000 feet high and heading home at 600 miles an hour.
It was probably no better day to have a Thanksgiving dinner, and definitely no better venue than to be on Air Force One.
Today, over 4 years later, the Presidential Airlift Group is back in the Middle East. They're about to wrap up an 8-day mission. These flights also signal the end of a longer journey for Colonel Tillman and President Bush.
I will miss a lot of aspects of the presidency. One thing I'll miss is Air Force One. This is a flying family. The people on this airplane work hard to accommodate the president and his party. They are gracious. They are fun to be with. And it is an honor to serve with them.
What I'll miss is the flying with all of these people that I work with. Well, I miss the responsibility and the worrying 24 hours a day to make sure everything's perfect for the President of the United States. No, I'm not going to miss that.
The mission of flying the president now passes on to Colonel Scott Turner.
Congratulations, sir. Good job. Thank you very much. It's all
my
yours.
Pleasure.
It's all yours.
The events of September 11th and the Baghdad trip really shaped the way we do business and shaped the presidency.
In what has become a tradition, the new pilot takes command of America's flagship. As the new president takes command of the United States. Colonel Turner's first official flight as the new pilot, pick up President-elect Obama in Chicago and fly him to Washington, D.C.
Hi, sir. Good afternoon.
My name is Scott.
Nice to meet you.
Good to see you.
You're
the pilot of Air Force One?
Yes, sir. It would be my pleasure to serve you as your pilot.
You know, I got to say, you're out of central casting. You're exactly what I want the pilot of Air Force One to look like.
Thank you, sir.
You look like you know how to fly. You look like Sam Shepard in the right stuff.
Thank you very much, sir. On behalf of everyone at Air Force One, I'd like to invite you, sir, welcome you aboard.
Thank you.
And introduce you to Reggie Dixon.
Welcome, sir. So nice to see you, sir.
My pleasure to meet you, sir.
Thank you so much.
Welcome aboard.
How long?
There is one thing he can be guaranteed, is the fact that the Presidential Airlift Group will be prepared and ready at all times. No question.
We're going to be serving dinner tonight. Not sure if you had dinner already. This is a menu we have available for you.
I'll see how you guys do a burger. Make it medium well.
By all means.
And cheddar cheese if you got the cheddar cheese.
Sir, you know I got it.
All right.
Cheddar cheese?
Cheddar cheese.
We have it.
And I take, if you have some Dijon mustard, whatever, that's what I'm going to take.
Okay.
And
Dijon or the Grey Poupon?
That's fine. And
okay.
Then lettuce tomato.
Yes, sir.
All right. Now, and if you have like some salad or some vegetables or something.
Yes, sir. No fries or anything like that?
Well, I'll still take the fries.
Yes, sir. Well, I can show you. I don't know if you want to see the rest of the airplane at this point in time.
Good to go. Right to 090.
Air Force One is Air Force One. It's not dependent on who's sitting in the chair. It is our responsibility to the office. And absolutely, of course, we will carry that forward into the same expertise and perfection we do today.
I, Barack Hussein Obama, do solemnly swear
that I will execute the office. A lot of aspects of the presidency. One thing I'll miss is Air Force One. This is a flying family. The people on this airplane work hard to accommodate the president and his party. They are gracious. They are fun to be with. And it is an honor to serve with them.
What I'll miss is the flying with all of these people that I work with. Well, I miss the responsibility and the, worrying 24 hours a day to make sure everything's perfect for the President of the United States. No, I'm not going to miss that.
The mission of flying the President now passes on to Colonel Scott Turner.
Congratulations, sir.
Good job. Thank you very much. It's all yours.
The events of September 11th and the Baghdad trip really shaped the way we do business and really shaped the presidency.
In what has become a tradition, the new pilot takes command of America's flagship as the new president takes command of the United States. Colonel Turner's first official flight as the new pilot? Pick up President-elect Obama in Chicago and fly him to Washington, D.C.
Hi, sir. Good afternoon.
My name is Scott Turner.
Nice to meet you.
Good to see you.
Yes, sir.
You're the pilot of Air Force One?
Yes, sir. It'll be my pleasure to serve you as your pilot.
You know, I've got to say, you're out of Central Casting. You're exactly what I want the pilot of Air Force One to look like.
Thank you, sir.
You look like you know how to fly. You look like Sam Shepard in the right stuff.
Thank you very much, sir. On behalf of everyone at Air Force One, I'd like to invite you, sir, welcome you aboard.
Thank you.
And introduce you to Reggie Dixon.
Welcome, sir. So nice to see you, sir.
My pleasure to meet you, sir.
Thank you so
welcome
much.
Aboard.
How long?
There is one thing he can be guaranteed, is the fact that the Presidential Airlift Group will be prepared and ready at all times. No question.
We're going to be serving dinner tonight. I'm not sure if you had dinner already. This is a menu we have available for you.
I'll see how you guys do a burger. Make it medium well.
By all means.
And cheddar cheese if you got that cheese.
Sir, you know I got it.
All right.
Cheddar cheese. We have it.
And I take, Dijon
Muscat
River, that's what I'm
going to
take.
Okay, and Dijon or the Great
Poupon? That's fine. And
okay.
Then lettuce tomato.
Yes, sir.
All right, now, if you have like salad or some vegetables or something.
Yes, sir, no fries or anything like that?
Well, I'll still take the fries.
Yes, sir. Well, I can show you, I don't know if you want to see the rest of the airplane at this point in time.
Good to go, right to 090.
Air Force One is Air Force One. It's not dependent on who's sitting in the chair. It is our responsibility to the office. And absolutely, of course.
Passes on to Colonel Scott Turner.
Congratulations, sir.
Good job. Thank you very much. It's all yours.
The events of September 11th and the Baghdad trip really shaped the way we do business and really shaped the presidency.
In what has become a tradition, the new pilot takes command of America's flagship as the new president takes command of the United States. Colonel Turner's first official flight as the new pilot? pick up President-elect Obama in Chicago and fly him to Washington, D.C.
Hi, sir. Good afternoon.
My name is
Scott. Nice to meet you.
Good to see you. You're the pilot of Air Force One?
Yes, sir. It'll be my pleasure to serve you as your pilot.
You know, I've got to say, you're out of Central Casting. You're exactly what I want the pilot of Air Force One to look like.
Thank you,
you look
sir.
Like you know how to fly. You look like Sam Shepard in the right stuff.
Thank you very much, sir. On behalf of everyone at Air Force One, I'd like to invite you, welcome you aboard.
Thank you.
And introduce you to Reggie Dixon.
Welcome, sir. So nice to see you, sir.
My pleasure to meet you, sir.
Thank you
welcome
so much.
Aboard.
How long?
There is one thing he can be guaranteed is the fact that the presidential airlift group will be prepared and ready at all times. No question.
We're going to be serving dinner tonight. I'm not sure if you had dinner already. This is a menu we have available for you.
I'll see how you guys do a burger. Make it medium well.
By all means.
And cheddar cheese if you got that cheese.
Sir, you know I got it.
All right.
Cheddar cheese?
Cheddar cheese.
We have it.
And I take, if you have some Dijon Muscle River, that's what I'm going to take.
Okay. Dijon or the Great Poupon?
That's fine. And then lettuce tomato.
Yes, sir.
All right. Now, and if you have like some salad or some vegetables or something.
Yes, sir. No fries or anything like that?
Well, I'll still take the fries.
Yes, sir. Well, I can show you, I don't know if you want to see the rest of the airplane at this point in time.
Good to go. Right to 090.
Air Force One is Air Force One. It's not dependent on who's sitting in the chair. It is our responsibility to the office. And absolutely, of course, we will carry that forward into the same expertise and perfection we do today.
I, Barack Hussein Obama, do solemnly swear
that I will execute the office